Smita, and you're watching Rendezvous with Smita Kumar at MediCircle. Today, at our show, we are speaking to Gautam Pasupuleti, CEO and Managing Director, Biodesign Innovation Labs, which is a medical device and healthcare company, supported by various organizations like Department of Biotechnology, BIRAC, Government of India, Government of Karnataka, Qualcomm, Camtek Global Health, Mass General Hospital, CC Camp, IKP, IIT Bombay, and Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. He is also one of the Forbes India's Ultimate 120 Pioneers of Change. Hi, Gautam. Welcome to MediCircle.
Hello. Thank you for the introduction. Nice to connect with you.
So how is Biodesign Innovation Labs focused on developing innovative yet affordable medical tech solutions that can save lives and improve the quality of life for all?
Yeah, so we initially started with this company, Biodesign Innovation Labs. Primarily, we found there was an unmet clinical need, which was a shortage of ventilators and leading to mortality with the existing standard of treatment and, you know, the low resource healthcare conditions, which primarily lead to mortality. And so to give a brief context of how we started, I come from a background of, you know, engineering and also from design background, and with a lot of emphasis on innovation and design and development, and more emphasis on social impact. And likewise, my brother was also part of this whole innovation, and we were part of this medical device innovations for the past 3-4 years before starting this company in 2017. And when I actually moved from Boston to Bangalore, we actually visited more than 100 plus hospitals across India. And we found there was an unmet clinical need, which was using prolonged manual ventilation in the referral hospitals, tertiary healthcare hospitals, which have very limited number of ventilators. And they usually refer the patients when there is a limited ventilators available. And the existing treatment is using bag, wall, and mask to keep the patient stable when the patient is usually having an emergency, you know, and say, for example, cardiac arrest leading to respiratory arrest, or a respiratory arrest leading to cardiac arrest. So you need immediate ventilation at that point of time until the patient is moved to a higher treatment. So we found this transition was very critical and very, you know, bottleneck for the whole healthcare system across India, because we visited north, south, east, west, across all the hospitals in India, mainly in the district hospitals, primary health centers, secondary health centers, government, private. And we found, when we kept hearing the same thing from the doctors, saying that, you know, this what happens in this scenarios, and, you know, the patients usually don't get enough ventilators when there is a emergency, like a patient with cardiac problems or patient with some casualty trauma, you know. So and that whole problem statement and need statement, clearly, we found there were no other people who were solving this particular problem in the whole emergency care and the transporting patients and the, you know, use of this prolonged manual ventilation. And that is when we started this company, Biodesign Innovation Labs, with our main product, Respirade, which is a portable mechanical ventilation device, which is a safe, reliable, affordable alternative for prolonged manual ventilation, such that it can save the lives of patients who need immediate ventilation, patients who need intubation, and patients who have to be sedated, and patients who has to be, you know, transported. And we're also talking about patients who has to be, you know, provided ventilation from the ambulances, emergency ward, all the way to the ICUs, and, you know, across the spectrum of healthcare, patients who are having respiratory problems or any other medical conditions leading to respiratory problem. And the primary objective is to save lives and to make healthcare more affordable and accessible. So if you look at the existing companies which are in the medical device, in the ventilators and other respiratory products, and you know, the big equipments, these are very expensive. A normal family cannot afford, you know, such treatments, which big hospitals, private hospitals, even government hospitals have very limited number. And that's why we want to make sure that, you know, we are bridging this gap. And that's how we started this company. And right now we have launched the product and we are across in hospitals in India right now. We are working with the government, you know, Karnataka government has supported us, the startup Karnataka. And we have also been funded by BIRAC, who has helped us with the R&D of our product, ventilator, respirate, and RESPAP for the bubble CPAP. Not just respirate, we have other respiratory therapeutic device products, which is also saving lives. For example, a bubble CPAP product, which can provide oxygen therapy for children with pneumonia, which saves the life of a patient for children under 5. And we have a respirate, which is again, essentially a ventilator, which saves lives when there is an emergency and patients have to be transported. And across usage in post-operative care. So post-operative care is when a patient who has gone through a surgery and they need to be ventilated, and the manual bagging also happens there. And you also have this equipment, anesthesia machines, which are really expensive. So we can reduce the treatment cost at the same time by reducing the equipment cost. And we can also make sure that our equipment is very at a very fraction of cost than what is available in the market, which is the products which are being imported. And like from the government policy, we want to make sure that, you know, Indian companies are, you know, much more reliable, you know, much more affordable, and something which can replace the imported products. At the same time, we don't compromise on the quality and the aspects to it. So we have make sure we've gone through all certifications and, you know, validation, testing, performance. And we've also worked with companies such as contract manufacturers for our large scale manufacturing. And we have also collaborated with a company called Remedio, with which we are working on mass manufacturing. So when the pandemic started, we started mass manufacturing with companies like Remedio in collaboration. So you cannot do everything by yourself. So you have to make some collaborations, especially when you're a startup. And that's when we really emphasize on making a social impact, which can make a difference.
That's really great. You have 28 honors and awards attached to your list, 6 publications and 5 patents. What drives your motivation?
So, like I said, for me personally, the objective is to make some a valuable product which creates a value that, you know, in the healthcare system, what we are looking at patients who needs affordable ventilators, patients who needs accessible products, which are in the rural areas, from the tertiary care hospitals to a tier 1 hospitals in the rural primary health centers, secondary health centers, where there is usually there are no ventilators or a shortage of ventilators. So when you go to these hospitals and you get the first hand experience by talking to these doctors, by observing these things, and that actually motivates your resource that you have and the expertise and skills that you have got through all your academics and working with the doctors and, you know, other clinicians, and you use all the knowledge to and your experience and resources to contribute for the society and for the country.
Tell us about your project on low cost ventilators.
Yeah, so the, like I have explained, so Respirate, we started in 2017. So in 2017, we received an award from the government of Karnataka, which was a grant, essentially funding our low cost ventilator Respirate, which solves the problem of prolonged manual ventilation. And we also received an award from in the year 2017 from Camtek Mass General Hospital's Innovation Award. And we got a Karnataka government grant, which helped us really do the R&D. And we have received several other grants and awards from BIRAC, Department of Biotechnology, and Department of Science and Technology, Nidhi Prayas Prototyping Grant, which really accelerated our R&D, because the ventilator is, we are developing from scratch, you know, which nobody has ever tried before. And we have got all the intellectual property filed, and we have made sure that all the technology is actually being developed from scratch without, having much to do with the replication of existing products. So we have developed an indigenous, innovative, totally new product, which actually solves a problem and saves the lives of patients. And right now it is being deployed across hospitals in India. And we're working with multiple partners, channel partners, and manufacturing partners, and licensing partners. And we have our own marketing partners to make this product distributed across India. And we have also applied for FDA and other, we have patents across countries like US, Canada, Australia, India, and other countries. So we also plan to expand to other countries. So parallelly looking at different partners in local regions, so we could really make sure that we can take the product and make it accessible across India and globally. And essentially it is solving the problem of prolonged manual inflation, and it is being primarily used in the emergency care and ambulances and transport ventilation and post-operative care.
You have been a startup mentor with Atal Incubation Center. How is it to mentor the young minds of a country? Or do you think India has the potential to be put on the world map in terms of innovations? Like,
yeah,
we are always in Jugar. We built with our own experiences. There has been lots of innovations done by Indians, comparatively, but not that good figure. But yes, we are into constant innovation. So what is your take on that?
Yeah, if you look at the innovation index, India is growing in terms of the most innovative countries in the world. So the more the ecosystem really plays a key role in nurturing the young minds to really come up with solutions that, you know, is actually solving a problem for the global issues. So when we look at preparedness and, you know, preparing the youth of the country is very important to make sure that they actually are self-sufficient and independent and can, you know, make their own decisions to really build organizations or, you know, contribute to existing organizations' innovations for our country, which really helps solve problem. So in order to do that, so not just colleges, but the whole startup ecosystem, right? From the government side, there has to be a lot of funding to fund these ideas, because students can have a lot of these ideas and they don't have funding to, you know, really take this research project to take it forward. So one end, you should have the colleges really support these research projects such that they can really take their third year, fourth year research projects to actually companies which solves the next big problem, next big Google, right? So so all these companies, like if you look at Stanford and all the in the US, so there is a support from the academia and there is support from the industry, because when you have, there is an ecosystem and the people who are actually, you know, the young mind who are really brilliant, who really gets to know all this technology and comes forward, takes initiative, the whole system has to support such that they can really take their visions and, you know, to forward into reality. So one of the things that I have learned is it really helped us. So our partners, like our incubation partners, like IKP Knowledge Park, or the government funding agencies like BIRAC, Startup Karnataka, Department of ITBT, Government of Karnataka, and Government of India's DBT, Nidhi Prayas, all of them, Qualcomm, all of them have provided like an ecosystem to really support us, not just in the funding, but also in the incubation and for the mentoring and for the right connections. So we can really ask the people, you know, who have succeeded before, and they can really guide us how we can take our own startup journey or entrepreneurial journey and really figure out a lot of things. So when you're doing for the first time, you'll have to figure out a lot of things, but you could really ask a lot of people who have already done this and, you know, get around solutions which you don't have to try it, and, you know, so that's what ecosystem really matters. So you have a knowledge transfer, you know, you have a complete know-hows and everything which is widely shared and best practices to succeed. So that's when I thought that since the ecosystem has contributed so much to my success and, you know, our startups, so, and a lot of these incubations and a lot of these universities have also reached out to me to give mentorship programs and give guest lectures. So I have also taken initiatives to take some of my time to really provide some mentoring and support some of the startups and students, early stage students. So it can really be useful for the next generation. Yeah.
How does it feel to be featured in Forbes India's Ultimate 120 Pioneers of Change?
Yeah, I think it's a great honor, and we feel humbled to have that. So like I said, when the COVID pandemic started, some of the doctors who are mentors in our company have really encouraged us to, you know, pursue this goal of manufacturing ventilators in the time of COVID during the March first week, second week. And we really worked hard, you know, 24 hours in a day, 24 hours, you know, we were working like 20 hours continuously, and then we take small breaks and then we come back, and it was going for months. So, and then we had a lot of issues, like challenges, like supply chain lockdowns, working during lockdowns. So yeah, it was really initially the spark, that someone has to create the spark, and then you really take that inspiration to get going, and you wanted to see the products come out and really go to the patients and have an impact, which we are doing right now. It all started with some small spark where one of our mentors, Dr. Anoop Rao, who was really a very good mentor, who has also helped us a lot, has also given us a lot of support for our startup, has really encouraged us to pursue this when the COVID pandemic started in India. And there was a really ventilator shortage. And we started this mass manufacturing ventilators with in collaboration with Remedio. And Biorezyn Labs team has really worked hard in collaboration with Remedio in mass manufacturing respirator portable ventilators, which essentially saves lives. Yeah,
that's great. So when we got them,
and that's when all the media, people started recognizing our work, your story, and Forbes, and it's really great and honor to get recognized. Yeah.
So I mean, it's really great and commendable for an Indian company to start an innovation right from scratch. Like in innovation in the field of medical devices, really the need of the hour. As you said, during the COVID, there was a need of lot of these respiratory devices, which were like not in that quantity and not produced in that much quantity. And I think it was not at all affordable also for a lot of Indians to go and have these. So it is, I think, a very good idea. And also it is in the exact time when it was needed. Because I think healthcare availability and affordability are two the most important issues of today's healthcare. And I think startups like you are really able to solve them. So it was really great, Gautam, coming on MediCircle and sharing such great innovative products and the ideas behind, so that lot of other startups and entrepreneurs, they should get this feeling that yes, we can definitely do something, and they can be inspired by the success stories of entrepreneurs like you. So all the best with all your future endeavors, and thank you so much for joining us on MediCircle.